My apologies for coming late. Thank you. Sorry. Bombay traffic, and I have a big leg issue. Okay. But I'm committed to Zahir Saab. And I just come back from Germany, and he said, I have to come. So I'm a very instinctive person.
Okay, before we proceed, a little bit about CrossFit. CrossFit aims to be a point of cultural and social interaction where authors and poets hold court, where children are regaled, where people gravitate to be informed, to be entertained, even enlightened. The name embodies the vision of CrossFit as a place and space for people who seek information, knowledge, or just the pleasure of reading.
Thank you so much. On behalf of Penguin Random House India, I'd like to welcome you all to the very special book launch of Dangerous Minds by Hussain Zaidi and Jesh Singh. As you've heard so far, you know, Dangerous Minds is a very special book. And these kind of books, I think, require a lot of hard work, diligence, research, and dedication to write. So I'd personally like to extend my thanks to Hussain. You've heard a lot about, you know, all the profiles, you know, now briefly about the book, you know. Basically, it tries to explore the mind of a terrorist, and in this particular case, the minds of homegrown terrorists. How very normal, everyday people like you and me take to the world of crime. What is the tipping point? What are their motivations? Read the book to find out more. I'd like to briefly introduce my authors here today as well. Hussain Zaidi, as you all like Black Friday, Domri to Dubai. My name is Abu Salim, and hopefully Dangerous Minds is going to enter the list very, very soon. It's been a real pleasure working with you and learning from you, Hussain. Thank you so much for writing the book.
Thank you, Mini.
Brijesh is a versatile person, I think by any measure, an engineer by training, a cop by profession. He's a writer. Also a very good cook, and I can vouch for that because he's cooked dinner for me once, Thai food. So he's a man of many talents, and he's also a Penguin author. He's written a book called Quantum Siege that we've published a few years back, and I'm a journalist, and Brijesh also objective, but he's also an insider and privy to a lot of, like, you know, details as he is a cop. So thank you to both of you. Thank you so much, Mr. Anil Kapoor, for being here despite your health condition and agreeing to launch
the book. Health is fine, yeah. Itna zyada mat bolo.
Well, I hope so, and I hope
I will find it. I will find it. 2 hours to reach here. Usme thoda gadbad ho gaya. Holy, the Hajjal is Kev's corner. It took me 1 hour.
But thank you so much. Indeed, it's a pleasure, sir, that you made it here and agreed to launch the book. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys.
It's a pleasure and honor to be here. After a long time, I come to this part of the city, you know, and so it's because I usually used to come with my girlfriend over here, who's my wife now, so to this Chinese corner, Games corner, and I have to come here also. So good to be back here.
Wonderful. May I ask Mr. Kapoor to please help us in launching the book finally? So if I could ask Ms. Aishwarya to join them on stage. We would have the unveiling of the book right now. Still photography first, and then we'll go to the video cameras, okay? Okay, may I ask the photographers to please take a seat while we have the video cameras rolling. If I could just ask all to stay for 2 more minutes, please. Thank you. To move forward, if I may please request Mrs. Zaidi to take this evening forward a conversation with our guest as well.
I think we had a lot of discussion. The guys must be very bored and tired now. So, और क्यों बात करना चाह रहे हैं हम? Yeah, yeah. I think I would ask Kapoor sir to say a few words, and you know, you have all been waiting for him. Please, sir. You all around, nobody's going to wait for me, because you know, and of course, you know, I haven't read the book, but I know about Zaheer Sahab a lot, and been a huge admirer of his work and the kind of hard work and the kind of research he puts in. I've done a film also, which was based on one of his books called Shurar Vadala. That's the time I came to know him and met him personally and interacted with him. A lot of other things we are talking about for the future, not only for doing it over here, but doing something internationally, which hopefully, fingers crossed, if it works, I'll be great. And of course, who's not interested in dangerous minds? You know, we all are interested in minds, and it's all about the mind. You know, life is all about mind, and it's intriguing. It's always, for me, it's always been intriguing as an actor. You know, to get into the psyche of a mind, and how a normal-looking person suddenly can be so dark and so dangerous, and then suddenly, the next moment, leading a very normal life, you know. So I want to get into that mind. I want to understand. I want to perform those characters. I want to read about them. You know, it can be, it's very, very intriguing, disturbing, exciting. You know, all these emotions you go through once you get into these kind of minds. And looks great. Looks fantastic. I wish Zaheer Sahab all the best. And Brijesh, I've met you for the first time. Congratulations. And it's great to be here. In this kind of an ambience, this kind of an atmosphere with so many people around over here. Thank you. It's an honor to be here. An honor today. I've got the honor to releasing this book with Zaheer Sahab and Brijesh Sahab and being in front of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you for those kind words, Ms. Kapoor. We will now have Mr. Harshal Shah to give our guests of honor a token of appreciation on behalf of Crossword. May I invite Mr. Harshal Shah? Is he around? May I have a big round of applause for them? You all can be seated now.
Thank you so much. What is it? I've got another gift. I'm getting another gift. Oh, my book. Okay, okay. Oh, thank you. 10 years old. She was collecting my. She's exposing my age. She says I'm collecting your books since I was 10 years. 10 years old. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. I'll come and see you after this book launch and we'll sit and discuss. But today it is all about dangerous minds, not about me. So I
thank
promise.
Thank you. Right, we now can do that later.
I promise. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you.
You can have
very
a seat.
Very sweet of you. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, very quick. We're going to, I know that we did this before, we had question and answers before, but if you want to throw anything at them last time, here's your chance. Questions? Anyone?
Yeah. What I want to know is that, so you've discussed about dangerous minds in this book, and you must have learned a lot about them. And sometimes through life, even the worst of people, sometimes you can have certain sympathetic views about them, or you know, there can be a certain reasoning.
Read these stories, they are also victims. They are victims of a whole system of manipulation, you know, of people sitting across the border, creating mechanisms to feed upon people who are innocent, and they get trapped. So it's actually a tragedy. And as
No, I don't feel sympathy for any of those guys who cause bloodshed of innocent people, kill them, harm them. No, there's no sympathy. I am very cold towards them. No feelings at all. Sorry.
So it's quite the other way around. The police officer is sympathizing.
No, the whole point is you are looking at it as an objective investigation. I must admit and stop. They can weed out all those nefarious elements from the community and throw them out and keep the name and reputation of the community intact. So that's why I don't feel any sympathy for them.
I have a question for you.
The cop is asking me a question. Okay. Scary, huh?
You know, you did on screen what we see in reality. And now, how did you relate to it? How did you get into that character?
Which character?
In 24, the recent one.
Yes. Yeah, 24 he's a pretty dark guy. He's a pretty dark guy. And he's a guy with a dangerous mind, 100%. I think somewhere, the kind of job, you know, these kind of jobs are very, very mentally and physically very taxing. And then, of course, he has to deal, interact, research, understand with all kinds of people who have dangerous minds. So somewhere you have to understand a dangerous mind, you have to have certain kind of dangerous mind yourself. So doing this character, obviously, I had to do a lot of research. You cannot do anything unless you really go deep into it. So I did go deep into it. I met a lot of people. I've got into a lot of trouble also in the past, trying to meet people and interacting with them. So they felt that I have some kind of, close relationship with these underworld people whom I met personally. I met cops, I've met officers on top, handling and interacted with them, spoken to them. I've met small convicts also. So I've met all kinds of, visited jails. So, and then of course today, the youngsters and all of us are very, very fortunate that you have the digital media, the internet, the YouTube, and so much material is available for you to really, if you really want to go deep into it, you can read them, you can meet them, you can listen to them, you can watch their videos. So it's a combination of so many things I have done. And of course, today, one of my reasons of my injury also is 24. Because it was such a physically exhausting and demanding role that I try to raise the bar. So trying to raise the bar, obviously you sometimes have to you get these kind of small injuries. So I've given my blood and sweat to 24 and to Jai Singh Rathod. It might not show on screen, but there's a lot of hard work behind doing this character.
One tricky question: when is the next season coming?
The next season, of course, it will be as soon as I start running. Now I can walk, I can talk, I can be come for this. All these events and so once I can start jogging and sprinting, the day I can sprint, that's the day I'm going to start 24, the third season. Unless, I'll become some senior kind of a guy. But 24, third season will be made, 100%, by the grace of God. Yeah.
Amazing news. Okay, any more questions? Right back.
Hi sir, I wanted to ask, majority of your books, at least the ones I know, are on a Indian context. So are you planning on writing? I'm asking you.
Well, I think that I'm from Mumbai and most of my readers are from India. So it's better to write about, the places, the people, the events which are about this country locally. I mean, if I write about Turkey or if I write about those alien places, people will not be able to identify. So it's very important that I should remain focused and hear about this place. Though I tried one in Mumbai Avengers, again, if you have read that fiction, I tried to write something about the international espionage, and that book was written thanks to Mr. Vijay Singh. The hero of that book is named Vijay Singh, actually, if you have read that book.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That was very embarrassing, you know.
You have another question?
Yeah, any three simple ways to counter terrorism?
हम दोनों को नहीं पता है।
Okay, question?
So you two all subject matter experts, it will be better to enlighten people since all Mumbaikars are generally facing a favor. Any simple things which we can do?
I think Vijay, you can answer, you're a comm. I'm here as an author, you know.
Okay.
Anybody it will else? Not stop until it comes from inside. See, this, as I said, that I said a little while ago that the community has to take a step, and they have to ensure that those who are, you know, bad elements from within the community, they have to be weeded out, they have to be removed. The community elders have to take charge and ensure that no bad name should come to us. That's the first step, that's the beginning. Uske baad I think second, third, uske baad follow up ho hi jayenge jo step bata rahe hain. I'm sorry, and we can, I was not prepared for this one.
And we can help them to weed out.
Okay, another question, sir.
Very big fan of all your writing.
Thank you.
I have one question for you. So you've written so many books, and how do you protect your informant's identity? And how do you sustain the rapport with your informants through your writings?
I don't protect my informants, I protect myself. The first thing, the second thing, that I don't wine and dine with them, and I treat them totally as the samples of pathologists I told you earlier. So I keep a safe distance from them. I never go to their weddings, I never call them to my functions, and I keep distance. And the idea is that once if someone says that don't disclose my name, or I spoke to you about so and so thing, so I never do that as a matter of ethics and principle. Once when I managed to interview Arun Gavli inside the Harsul jail in Aurangabad, one joint commissioner, he called me at that time and he said, how did you manage to go inside and speak to him? I said, no, as a matter of principle, I cannot disclose how I managed to go inside. So he said, there is a CRPC Act Evidence 60 where I can summon you and I can force you to reveal the source and the way you went inside. I said, sir, try that. I would rather go inside for jail for 3 months, but I will not tell you how I did that. So I was not protecting that informant. I was protecting myself and my profession. That's it.
Thank you.
Context with 24 only. So I really love 24, both the seasons I've watched, been a big fan of the show. My entire family has been a big fan of the show. So you must have done a fair bit of research regarding the character and whatever goes on. So I wanted to ask, according to your research, whatever you've done and whatever how you've played the character, what drives these people to do these horrific acts, you know? What drives these people to do things that affect so many people? What blinds them at that moment? What's the impulse behind them?
You're talking about the opposite? The opposition?
Yeah. The opposition.
The opposition. You know, I feel, as Brijesh Sahab was saying, first of all, most of them are brainwashed. You know? And, you know, the people who are doing really something which is, which you cannot even dream of, somewhere I feel they are brainwashed. And I think a lot of people are there for the money also, you know. So this is my, it's money, power, you know, all these things are there, and brainwashed. I think that must, these are things. And of course, they are brainwashed to think that they are being patriotic. They are brainwashed that they're doing it for the cause. You know, for them it might be the cause, but they're convinced about it. So they're brainwashed to that extent. And we think that they're being, not being, doing the right thing, and they're not being, you know, they are, but they are convinced that what they're doing is right. So they are completely brainwashed. So it's a combination of many things. So it depends on person to person the you're talking about. So there are certain criminals who are doing only for power, only for money. And there are some criminals who are brainwashed, or terrorists, whatever, whoever you're talking about here.
Thank you. Okay, with this we come to the end of this book launch session. Thank you everyone for being here. On behalf of Crossword and Penguin, I'm thanking all of you everywhere, and of course special thanks to all of you for giving your time, spending your time with us over here. Thank you. It means a lot to us all. All right. What we're going to do is we are going to have authors to sign books, so you can collect your copies and get them signed in line. All right. Once again, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.